Everyone, Tim and Nev here from Box 33. Today we're going to be talking about ankle mobility. Now the word mobility, something's thrown around quite a lot. For the purpose of this video, we just want to exchange the word mobility for movement. So we're going to be looking at the movement of the ankle. So firstly, just a couple of quick tests you can do to see, you know, what the movement in your ankle is like. And I'll almost go as far as saying that just about every person could benefit from doing more ankle movements. Okay, so the first test is I'll get Nev just to lean back against the wall so he's nice and stable, and I'll just come down. And we're just going to do dorsiform plantar flexion. So bring your foot up, and it's just basically from the ankle going active and bringing the toes back towards the shin, and then pressing the toes away from the shin, and then back towards, and then away. So Nev, probably not a good example because he has really good movement through his ankle. And now testing motor control of the ankle. So he would do some nice smooth circles with the ankle, and we're a bit rough here. Okay, so you can see it's not quite a nice smooth circle. And for this one, the drill, the test becomes the drill. So what I'll do is I'll get Nev just to slow it down. And if I just create like a nice little image of a circle here for him and just get him to slow it down and make the movement nice and smooth. Okay, so he smooths it out so there's no chunks in the circle. He's not doing triangles or squares. And then change directions. Good. Beautiful. Okay, and then the next one we'll do is inversion and eversion. So standing up nice and tall, and he's just going to basically roll out onto the outer edge of his foot. Okay, so be feeling a nice little pulling or stretching sensation up the side of his shin, and then back to neutral. And he just keeps rolling out in this position. One of the main reasons why people will actually roll their ankles is, you know, not because they have weak ankles, it's because their ankle does not know or understand what the limit of the range of motion is, because they don't teach the nervous system what it is by actually doing this movement. Okay, so by doing it, we can prevent it. We're reducing the range between active and passive range of motion. And now rolling inwards, same direction. It's a little bit more of an awkward movement. And a lot of people are quite jammy in this movement, so just really focusing on creating some space on the inside of the ankle joint. Beautiful, sort of anywhere from 5 to 10 repetitions. And now we can incorporate it in more dynamic movement, because this is ultimately where life happens. It happens through movement, right? And most people will hurt their ankles or roll their ankles playing sport, and it's usually through dynamic movement. So if we get Nev to start here, and he could just start by doing a little bit of walking, and he's elevating his toes, so he's walking on his heels. So keeping the toes up off the ground. 10 to 20 paces. Okay, turn around, face this way again. This time, he'll come up onto his tippy toes. Really great for foot health as well, not just the ankles, great for all the little bones. The foot is made up of lots of tiny little bones. Now, walking on the outer edges of the feet. This alone will be quite challenging for people. And then coming back, doing the T-Rex, walking on the inside edges of his feet. Great. So ankle movement and foot health in general, even if you can't remember these drills specifically, just think about the foot and the way it moves. Even just sitting down, quickly Nev, even just sitting down, crossing one leg over, grabbing hold of the foot, and just moving the bones, articulating the joint, and just moving the foot and toes, you know, even putting the fingers in between your toes, you know, and creating space between the toes, like much like what a little child's foot would look like naturally. And just really paying attention to your feet. I feel like the ankles and the feet are largely overlooked in gym routines, and yet we rely on them to get ourselves around every single day. So that 5-10 minutes, you know, a couple times a week where you can spend giving some love to your ankles and to your feet is gonna go a long way. Thanks for listening.